And we're live, guys. Welcome to another episode of Good Morning Crypto. Only here, only on Ivan on Tech. We are, of course, broadcasting live straight out of Stockholm, Sweden, and we do the show each and every day at 8 a.m. Central European Summertime, guys. I come to you like an atomic clock each and every day. Today we have interesting markets, to say the least. We have interesting markets because they're all down. Everything in crypto is down right now. Many people are worried. Many people are wondering how could this happen. Not many people were expecting this, although some technical indicators did indicate a downwards movement, but maybe not as strong as we've seen. So today we're going to discuss really what happened. I mean, how can we move so quickly in such big motions? Really, if you look at the chart, which I will show you, and you look at yesterday, we moved basically $1,000 in Bitcoin. We moved down in 2 hours. 1,000 in 2 hours. Extremely, extremely quickly. And obviously, this is something that we all are expecting in the crypto markets. These are crazy markets. So the first topic will be, of course, the dump. Why are we seeing it? What is going on? And what kind of strength does the market have? That's going to be number one. Number two, we're going to talk about Warren Buffett, because Warren Buffett is stacking cash like crazy. He's not stacking equities, he's not stacking bonds, he's not stacking anything else except cash right now. Very important development that we all need to keep in mind. And obviously, this is a sign of a potential recession. We will be talking about that, and it is an important topic for crypto, obviously. The potential recession we're seeing right now in the US and across the world could be the opportunity of our lives, really. Keep it in mind. And finally, we have XRP. We have XRP drama. XRP hodlers are begging Ripple company to stop dumping XRP. And here we will be discussing algorithmic liquidation, and we'll be discussing what this debate is really all about. They're also collecting signatures. They want to collect 10,000 signatures in order to stop Ripple from dumping XRP. So all in all, this is going to be a value and knowledge packed episode, and it is amazing to see all of you here. I see Francis, shout out Sean, Keltz, N Dog House, Betters, Michael Gulp, everyone, extremely, extremely welcome to the show. Hope for all, Moonshield. Let me know where you're coming from. Let me know which country, which continent, which planet you're tuning in Good Morning Crypto from. Because as you probably know, we're all evangelists. I really like this term somebody coined yesterday. I think it was Ruslan who coined this yesterday. We're all evangelists, and it is amazing to have you here. And by the way, let me know what you're drinking. Today we're drinking black coffee, but you probably know that. And in this black coffee, there is no milk and no sugar involved. Okay, looking at the markets, let's take a look. We have Bitcoin at minus 5.3%. We have Ethereum at minus 8.4%. We have Ripple XRP at minus 5.13%. And later we will talk about this petition where XRP hodlers are begging Ripple to stop dumping. We have Bitcoin Cash at 7.5%, Litecoin 8.9%. I mean, it's really a slaughter. The biggest slaughter in the top 10 is Binance Coin, minus 10%. Looking at the big winners, we do see some winners, but really it is a pathetic number of winners. We have only 6 winners out of thousands and thousands currencies listed on CoinMarketCap. So 9% in Hedgetrade, 7% in Solve, Stratis 3%, Golem 2%, and the big losers are Ren, vSystems, Algorand. So yes, we do see very, very forceful moves. Also, guys, today we have this webinar. We're going to talk about how to make money in a bear market, really in any market. Number one, we're going to talk about how to build wealth in crypto. Number two, and we're also going to talk about how to get involved in crypto and become a builder without being a programmer. So definitely check it out in the description. Completely free webinar. I forgot to tell you, but it's important. And if you have been in this webinar before, you don't need to attend. So, this is very important as well. The fact that yesterday, 150 million worth of longs were liquidated on BitMEX. So, obviously, many people were expecting an upwards movement. And if you look at the time frame we're talking about yesterday, this is really two candles. I mean, it is this smaller candle right here, and then this big one right here that basically tanked everything. And we're looking at 30-minute candles. So, really, I mean, you look within 1 hour, we went from 10.2 down to 9.5, which was the lowest mark, and now we're approximately at 9.5 once again. So this move was extremely, extremely quick, and you do understand that, I mean, it's all about using markets movements to your advantage, both up and down. Both up and down are now very, very good opportunities. So if you aren't on Bybit, definitely check it out. Use the link below to get $60 for free. And obviously you can short, you can long, you can do whatever you want. And although shorting is dangerous because you have more downside than upside, because really your maximum upside is 100%, but the downside can be huge. While when you're longing, you have better risk reward ratio, but still many people are using this to their own advantage today. Something very important that we need to discuss is this CoinMarketBook. I really saw Box Mining talking about it. To understand this dump, really need to understand what kind of positions you and I are in right now, because we are in a very special position. We are normal market participants. We're not whales. And you do understand, when you're a normal market participant, you cannot really deduce exactly what's gonna happen, because the market is so small and a small group of people can really move it a lot. I really also like this meme. Check it out. These are the whale traders. They're throwing this ball, and this is us basically. We're this dog trying to follow the shadow of the ball. I mean, while it is a funny picture, I think it summarizes the whole market very, very well. So when Bitcoin is dumping 10%, 5%, 10%, I mean, during the bear market, it could be even more severe. You do understand that you and I, we don't have a lot of insight, and with the best technical analysis in the world, it's also very difficult to draw any great conclusions. So therefore, we need to just look at the market and try to understand how strong the market is in this particular case. And therefore, I definitely think you should check out CoinMarketBook. And the good thing with CoinMarketBook is that they show you the strength of the market. They show you the strength of the different cryptocurrencies in terms of buy support. So you see, for example, Bitcoin, Ethereum, XRP, Bitcoin Cash, and so on and so forth. And then you have buy support right here. And this is basically the sum of all buy orders within 10% of the price. So basically, how much money do you need in order to tank the price 5%? 10%, not 10%, because this is the 10% range. So in Bitcoin, you have almost $400 million in buy orders within 10% of the current price, meaning that if you really wanted to dump Bitcoin, you need approximately $400 million, and you will be able to dump it with 10%. But I also think you will need less than that, because this is like the maximum amount of money you need. Because once you start tanking the market, a lot of these buy orders are gonna disappear, because obviously they can remove buy orders. The participants in the market, they can remove their buy orders whenever they want. So if they see a big movement downwards, if you really try to tank the market and you start tanking and you think you need $400 million, you will soon realize that, I mean, maybe you only need 200 and in order to reach 10% downward movement. So just to estimate how much money really was needed to go from 10.2 to 9.5, I mean, approximately 10%, a bit less than 10%, you can say it is maximum 400 million, but could be less, at least with the current buy support. Obviously, we need to know what it was yesterday with this buy support, but it is approximately quite similar from day to day. And you also look, I mean, some coins are very, very scary when it comes to buy support, like crypto.com chain. You only need 200k to drop it by 10%. You look at Decred, also 300k. You look at, let's sort it by the least, the weakest buy support. Yeah, approximately $200k needed for Civic, Solve, and others. So you realize how thin these markets are. And all in all, this is us. We're just this dog following the shadow, and the whales are doing their own business. And obviously, whenever you see people using leverage, and many people are using leverage without really knowing how to do it, and that is why I always tell you to be extremely careful with leverage, but many people are also having these conspiracies. I mean, could, for example, BitMEX manipulate the market and liquidate their own users? I mean, could they do it or not? Theoretically, they could. Practically, I don't know. If that would be discovered, it would be the biggest scandal of crypto. But nothing is impossible in crypto. That is the thing. We're living in an in an industry and we're participating in this industry where everything is possible. In this world, everything is possible. But this is a conspiracy, really. Who knows what's happening? So definitely something to keep in mind, because yesterday, within 1 hour, 150 million worth of longs just got liquidated. And obviously, a few months ago, many people discussed this fact that when you see people getting liquidated back and forth, both longs and shorts, everyone's getting liquidated, that is when people started to suspect a bit, man, maybe this is something happening. Maybe this is something happening on the back end where people are really going after traders on leverage platforms. So we'll see. We'll see, guys. It's still unknown. Thank you for the donation. Someone did a donation. What's up? What's up? Risk management through broad asset diversification, not just crypto. Not stop losses. I'm not sure what you mean with not stop losses. I think everyone should be using stop losses and you should calculate your risk position. But yes, probably diversifying a bit is a good idea. And that being said, I want to move on to the next topic, because at the end of the day, nobody can tell you exactly what caused this market, but we can all agree that we do have a few significant whales in this market. We do have quite weak buy support across the board. Even Bitcoin has quite weak buy support, and therefore you just need to be careful and think long term. I mean, this is the only conclusion I can give you. Think long term about your part of the crypto market and about where you want to be in the crypto market, because short term your nerves will be going all in. They will be going on full speed, your nerves, because these dumps and pumps happen all the time. And you see how weak buy support we have even in Bitcoin. I mean, 400 million might seem like a lot, but you see how easy it is and how quick it is to dump it by 10%. 400 million is not a lot, basically what I'm trying to tell you. So all in all, use CoinMarketBook if you just want to check. Also, you should use another site, because I mean, the volume is another variable that is important. So you should use Open Market Cap as well, just to compare to Coin Market Cap. Look at this. On Open Market Cap, you have volume of Bitcoin at 1.7 billion. So for one day, 24 hours, we do see a volume of 1.7 billion. And then you go to Coin Market Cap. And suddenly here on CoinMarketCap, it is 18. So which one is it? Is it 18 or is it 1.7? It's a very important question, because if we cannot answer this, if we cannot say, you know, is it this or is it this, you realize that no ETF and no serious financial product will be built in crypto. And because we do have so much wash trading and nobody really knows what the hell is happening, it's extremely difficult to create these financial products on top of Bitcoin. And many people feel that they are important. I think they are important in many ways, but they're also not that important in other ways. We can survive without having an ETF. It's not like it's a life necessity, but it would be nice to have an ETF. But with these discrepancies in the numbers, you don't know, man. I mean, how can you build a serious financial product on top of it? So we're so early on. This is also another aspect. We're so early on where buy supports are very thin. We have the situation with whales and the dog, and also who knows what the volume is. On that note, I want to conclude my first topic, which is about Bitcoin, which is about Bitcoin price and Bitcoin dump. And the next topic will be about Warren Buffett, because, man, Warren Buffett is preparing for the recession. And Warren Buffett knows a lot of things that you and I don't know. And you realize when the recession comes, this is the greatest time of opportunity. And while it's important to acknowledge that many people will lose their job, I mean, there are many horrible things that will happen during a recession. But when you are in the financial markets, you realize that there are no opportunities during good times, especially like 2017, 18, 19. Although stock market has been performing very well during those years, it is still very, very difficult to invest for example, millennials, because they feel like they're buying the top. And in many cases, they are. But who knows how long it will continue. So all in all, you realize that while recession is horrible in many ways, it's also the greatest opportunity in other ways. And I think we need to appreciate that. And I think this is something that everyone needs to know. And one of the biggest indicators right now of a coming recession is Warren Buffett, because this man is stockpiling cash like crazy. He hasn't had so much cash since 2008, basically. So he has sold a lot of equities He has sold a lot of bonds and now he's basically all in cash. Not all in, approximately 50%, but for him to be 50% in cash is quite significant. So all in all, right now he's quite quiet about what's happening in the US and he's quite quiet about the equities and the market. However, he is hoarding $122 billion in cash. Leading to some speculation that he sees a recession on the horizon. Because why would you want cash otherwise? Well, you want cash because when everything crashes, you pick up your war chest and you buy up cheap equities, you buy up cheap real estate and everything else of value that crashes. Because, I mean, the prices are quite inflated right now. We've been going up for 10 years. So it would be an amazing opportunity if we could see 30-50% correction in equity markets and also maybe in the housing markets, but housing is not performing that well either in many countries even today. Even in Sweden, it's going slow. So mainly, I think it is about equities. And so the only time that percentage has been reported, basically 50 cash and 50 assets that Warren Buffett has right now, the only time it has been higher since 1987 was in years leading up to the 2008 financial crisis. So he's prepared, man. He is prepared 100% to take full advantage of the coming potential recession. But this is the thing. You never know when it will happen. So sitting 100% in cash is not a good idea either, because the stock market can go up 30% more and then it drops by 30%, and basically that is why it is a good idea for many people to have some money in the markets but also have a lot of cash on the sidelines waiting to be deployed. So you realize how great of an opportunity this could be for everyone who knows that this is happening and who is not listening to the mainstream media. Because if you listen to mainstream media, you listen to Trump, you listen to everyone else online who is financial expert, many of them will tell you that the economy is doing great, we are at our greatest point, this has never been greater, the employment is all-time high, this and that, but this is not the full picture. I mean, obviously, these people want to get re-elected in a few months, because the elections are very soon. So this is definitely something that everyone needs to keep in mind. Recessions are great in many cases if you are prepared, but they are also horrible, because if you're not prepared, you are basically plankton, as I tell you guys, and you don't want to be that. Now, the final topic before we dive deep into the chat. The final topic is about XRP. The fact that XRP hodlers, by the way, let me know if you are an XRP hodler. Let me know if you're hodling XRP and if you think this is gonna moon. Because in 2017, it's been an incredible mooning asset. And while many people question the fundamentals, the pump fundamentals have been fantastic. So basically, we have this petition on change.org saying that Ripple should stop dumping. And the crypto bitlord started this and he's writing, Ripple continue dumping billions of XRP on us, crushing the price. Every day there is good news, a new bank or partnership announced, but still it manages to keep on dumping. The only logical explanation is that Ripple are dumping on us, and not small amounts either, literally billions. We have seen the reports of them disclosing this, so it is a fact. Now imagine, guys, I want you to imagine for a second, close your eyes right now and imagine a world where those coins aren't dumped. Man, I mean, imagine a world where all of these bitcoins are not dumped and we see just upwards movement. Man, that would be a good world. Where the buyers get to buy without dumping and the price, without dumping and price suppression. Man, this would be amazing. Imagine this in any market. It would be amazing. And you and I both knows what happens. We pump like good old days. Now we need over 10,000 signatures to help support the cause. So basically what they're talking about is algorithmic liquidation, and this is something that Ripple allegedly, like I don't know for 100%, but if you speak to people at conferences, you speak to people who are working with market makers, you realize that many of them have this suspicion about algorithmic liquidation. And this basically means that market makers of Ripple are helping them to sell Ripple on the market, basically dump Ripple on the market, dump XRP on the market. But they do it in such a way that it's very difficult to see, and in such a way that the price is not too affected. I mean, it is a selling pressure, but it's not like they're dumping their own coin. I don't know if it is true, but this is what speculations are. So this is what they're talking about, really, that Ripple needs to stop liquidating their positions. But at the same time, this is how they are funded. I mean, to be honest with you, why otherwise they created this asset? Well, they need to cash in somehow. So the easiest way to cash in is to dump on the market. So this is what happens when you have a company holding so much of your asset. I mean, I think it is good that the XRP army are now realizing it, because for the longest time, if you mentioned this, they would get super upset and like, hey, this doesn't matter. It's all good, all rainbow, all unicorn and sunshine, okay? But no, you realize that at the end of the day, it's not. And who in their mind would not dump this asset if you have like billions of this asset? I mean, Ripple really have so many of these XRP tokens. And obviously, would they not use the opportunity to make some money? Absolutely, absolutely. If it is the case that they're doing that, like, we don't know for sure. But according to this article, they know for sure. And you know, it is likely, it is likely. And you also have an uprising in Twitter. Basically, people are writing, Brad Garlinghouse, Joel Katz, you now have 60 days to stop dumping XRP or we will stage a community takeover. I don't know what that is. I mean, how can you stage that? Because you don't have any rights. You just have a token and you maybe it will be used for something in the future. Maybe not. But most probably, I don't want to speculate because who knows. But right now, it's not used for much. So how will you stage a community takeover is my biggest question. If it is a decentralized network, like you say, we have the power to do it. Man, what power? You have zero equity in the company. How will you stage it? Will you remove the CEO? Well, you don't have any voting rights. You need to have equity for that. So all in all, I'm not sure what they're talking about, but maybe they can stage something. Then they continue talking about the fact that XRP sales are about helping expand XRP utility. So this is the response that we need to sell because we need to build and building RippleNet and supporting other biz building Ripple and so on and so forth. So yeah, so that therefore they need to sell, they say. But anyway, guys, this is the situation. I just wanted to update you. I'm sure that we will have XRP fans in the comments and that's completely fine. But at the same time, I think it's also important to highlight this stuff. What is happening in the chat? What's up, chat? What is going on? I mean, the chat, I love the chat. I love it. I always tell you this, but I really mean it. I really mean it. Should be named the Garly. Yeah. I like his name, actually. I like his name. It's a name you can remember. Garlinghouse. Yeah. Nice name, actually. I'm on take. I know I could check myself, but what is fear index? It was already very... I think it is a lot of fear right now. I also checked last week. I haven't checked since last week. But if it was a lot of fear last week, let me bring it up. Fear index, crypto and fear index. Yeah. I think last week it was even bigger. I don't know how accurate this is, to be honest with you. Last week it was at 5, I remember. It was here, so everyone was freaking out. Now it is at 20, but the price has dropped even more. So who knows how accurate this is, but there you go. It's still a lot of fear, extreme fear. It sounds scary, but at the same time, this is also where the opportunities are. I mean, if you buy here when it's all green, I don't know if there's much opportunity in that. But not financial advice, guys. You never crap on Bitcoin, Ivan. Maximalists are so... I'm not sure what you mean, man. I'm not a maximalist. Look at my other streams. We talk about all kinds of things. Wish you kept a Bitcoin live chart or even just numbers. We are tanking because... Not sure, man. Sometimes we have very positive streams. And if you think that, you know, a YouTuber can influence the market, man, come on. Let's see. I hold both BTC and XRP, but XRP tech way ahead of BTC. Well, could be, but you see, it's all about censorship resistance and decentralization at the end of the day. And as you can see, people are not really liking the decentralization in Ripple at least. But we'll see. I mean, look, if they can stage a community takeover, as they say, if it is a decentralized network, like they say, they should have the. I agree. So maybe they can stage something. We have to follow, man. If BTC goes below gold price, I'm all in on Bitcoin. So you mean like for 1 ounce, or what do you mean? Because if you look at the market cap, we're nowhere near. For us to be at market cap of gold, we need to be at 380k. What do you think for Bitcoin in today? I mean, this is too short term. Who knows? Who really knows? Anyone's guess, man. That is why I think you should be thinking long term. Hey, Ivan, Pereshchev on Twitter saying he was right. He's always right. I mean, that is the thing. You listen to him, he's always right. And in the base, he's always right. He doesn't listen to anyone. But at the same time, we went from 3K to 10K in just a few months. So you realize how wrong he really is if you just zoom out. But obviously, everyone can be right on the short term. Very, very easy to be right on the short term. Ivan, what is your favorite brand of coffee beans? Kels, I wish I could give you a good answer, but I'm just buying coffee from the store. Maybe I should start doing my own coffee with my own beans. But at the same time, it's not something like I do right now. We also see a question about multisig, and actually we do have a whole course on Bitcoin programming, and you can check it out in our academy. So all in all, multisig is you can do it with simple scripting in Bitcoin, and definitely check out our courses in our academy. You will learn so much when it comes to Bitcoin programming there. What do you think about ETC, Binance Lending? Do you mean Ethereum Classic, or you mean etc.? Ethereum Classic on the tech level, I don't see a lot on the tech level. Not many people are using it. I mean, it even feels that more people are using Tron and stuff like that than Ethereum Classic. But yes, and Binance Lending has launched. Correct. We discussed Binance Lending a few days ago. And basically, it's all about the fact that crypto companies are becoming the new banks in many cases. Schiff is exactly. He's entertainer, and also, you see, when he is in debates, it's not a debate. I mean, nobody will convince Peter Schiff, and he will never be convinced. And he is not about he doesn't want to convince you, really. He has his talking points, and he just goes ahead and says everything, and that's it. And he's super confident, and that's it. And you know, if you look at the short term, you can always find the price corrections. I mean, even in gold, everywhere. And I think it's also a bad argument in many cases, because both gold and Bitcoin are wonderful. It's not like gold is worse than they're different. I mean, they're so different. How can you compare gold and Bitcoin? But gold does indicate the potential of where Bitcoin can go. So that is why I'm telling you 380k would be my long-term vision for Bitcoin. Have you seen Andreas's book on Lightning? I haven't, man, but I have seen that they launched it. Let's see. Mastering Lightning. I saw some kind of I didn't watch the video, but I saw Mastering Lightning, Andreas. But I saw they kind of unveiled it or something. That would be super cool. So yeah, he created the repository. Can you check the repository? Is there any documents there right now? Let's see. Yes. We do see some documents, but not a lot. Let's see. Yeah, so no, we don't see. He just started it, it looks like. Initial paragraph. Nice. Well, the best thing is to start. I mean, the hardest thing is to start. Sometimes it's amazing. Sometimes when I was in university, like the hardest thing was to just open up the document and start. So as long as you've opened up a new document, as long as you've written the title, man, you've done so much progress. And I really mean it. Like when you need to create a report, or you need to create some kind of work, or you need to write something, you can procrastinate it for weeks, but once you've opened up a new document, once you've created the title, well, then it will take like a few days and you're finished. So I think this is good. I think he will finish it quite fast, actually, because he has all the knowledge needed. It's not like he needs to research. Peter Schiff doesn't need to take the risk we're willing to take. I like his reasoning, but I ain't rich as he is. I don't know how rich he is, but he's gotta be rich because, yeah, he has this gold. I think he has a bank, is that correct? Like Pacific Bank or something? So he has done a lot of great things. I mean, that is for sure. That is for sure. Elon Musk endorses Dogecoin, and he's right. Start is hard, and finish. For me, it was always as soon as I have the title, I'm in the game. I'm in the game. Okay, he's starting in September in collaboration with two others. Okay. Yeah, I haven't been following exactly who will write it and when they will write it, but amazing. I think it's amazing, and I think you and I can also contribute. It's always like that with open source, but yeah. So he's gonna write it with Ola Luva and Renee. Nice. This guy is on YouTube. I know this guy, Renee. He's done some lightning action. Pretty complex. I think he knows a lot. He's very smart. He has done a lot of complicated things here that I've watched and tried to follow and try to understand. But you really need to have a lot of math, like Introduction to Schnorr. This one I watched, and you need to have some serious university math here. But it is amazing. I think this guy knows a lot. So gonna be interesting. Why is crypto market? Rewatch, man. Rewatch the stream. We have already talked about it. Crown's crypto got it wrong over the past couple of days. He's a great guy, but he was far too bullish. Not his fault though, as technicals, many people were bullish. I'm not too updated, but I even think the moon was bullish. So we're all biased in many ways. I mean, when you are in crypto, you're all biased. I'm biased, you're biased. It's too easy to be too bullish, because obviously, especially when you have your own skin in the game, it's not that fun to talk about that, hey, we're collapsing, you know, it might collapse. But that is why more people are biased towards bullishness. So, Ivanotech has an Ivan. You mean Rene? Yeah. I mean, this guy is amazing. I think he's very good. Check him out. But you need to have some math skills to follow him. At least what I've seen. If Bitcoin was a business with this amount of computing power and number of employees, what would be the value? I don't think you can just count the power of number of employees, because the value of a business is all about cash flow and future predictions. So you look at Uber, you look at for even Amazon. I mean, they're not making money. Uber is not making money because they are reinvesting and they have so much infrastructure. Amazon is not making money because they're reinvesting everything basically into the future, but they do have so much cash flow. It's just that they're reinvesting everything. So the value is based on cash flow and future expectations. Now, with Bitcoin, it is similar. Like the price of Bitcoin today is mostly about future expectations. How it will be used, you know, will it be digital gold? Will it be transactional? All in all. But employees, I don't think you can value business based on employees, because it's just a burden. So, I mean, you could be valuing it and see employees as a burden, and you know, you have a very big costs when it comes to your staff. But it can also be a good thing because you have so much talent. So, I mean, it goes both ways. But I don't think this comparison is too valid. Bitcoin is not a business. Like, it doesn't have cash flow. But it does have future expectations. So in that way, it's similar. Johnny, $10. Nice man. I can buy like two coffees with this. Amazing. Thank you so much. Shout out to Johnny Ortiz. What if Moon Boys are wrong? So, see, now people will really, really confirm this. So here is where everything we're gonna collapse. You know, this is Moon Boys are wrong, but that is where the most opportunities are, when we're here in the greed and fear index. When we are here in the green, everyone's happy. Everyone is going to the moon. That is when we crash. That is when we go from 20 to 3K. So, all in all, Da Vinci called 7.2. Yeah, actually, Da Vinci called this in many ways, because I also saw him on Tone Ways. I don't know, man. I don't know what to say about that video. Have you watched it? I don't know what to say about that video. I think you should definitely watch it. It was funny, but also, it was a bit painful to watch because Tone was a bit disrespectful to Da Vinci. He was basically trolling Da Vinci all the time. Like, I like Tone, I like Da Vinci, I don't want to say anything negative about Tone, but I mean, you look at this, he's trolling Da Vinci all the way. But here, I mean, this was right before the dump, I think. Right before the dump. And here Da Vinci actually said that he is bearish. He drew this triangle, he said that he's bearish. But yeah, this was a bit painful to watch. But I think you should, because it was good info. But maybe it's a bit outdated now because it moves so fast. I mean, the information there is not up to date anymore. Da Vinci was good once. I think he's still good. But I'm not watching, like, this is the thing. I don't have a lot of time to follow everyone and watch everyone. But I always enjoyed watching him. Despite the drop, I've bought more EOS, as it's half the price. And I know in the... Yeah, so voice is going to be very interesting. But they need to get, 1.8. EOS 1.8 out. I'm not too sure on the timeline. I interviewed the guys, the block producers, a month ago or so, 2 months ago. And they weren't too sure either when it's going to come out. Because EOS needs to upgrade their whole network and they're still doing that. So the update is done, but they need to deploy it. How much does Bitcoin message? Okay. VFU Berlik timed you out. VFU Berlik, I see you time out many people. Is it because they're spamming or why? Because, yeah, but I think you asked how much does it cost to run a full node? I mean, it depends. You can run it on your computer, basically. It's not. It also depends which if you have pruned version or not pruned version. But it's not too expensive. It just takes a lot of time. Man, VFU Berlik, he's timing out everyone. hey, VFU Berlik, let me know why you're banning timing out people. He hates caps. Yeah, I mean, to me, caps are not a problem. So, I mean, VFU, no need to time out everyone for caps. It's okay. Will you interview any main BSV people? I mean, who will I interview? Maybe I can interview the Jimmy guy. I think he is... if anyone, I would like to interview Jimmy. Because actually, when Jimmy talks, it makes a lot of sense. It makes a lot of sense. But at the same time, then Craig comes into the picture and the whole pitch kind of... Yeah, yeah. It's like in this... what is it? Oxford. Oxford, Jimmy Nguyen... Like, here, you see, Jimmy started so well. I'm like, man, I'm inspired. Because, like, it's all about selling. Jimmy's a salesman. So he can sell a Bitcoin Satoshi vision. Like, he's talking here. I'm like, man, I mean, it's good. It's good. In many cases, it's good. Yeah, but then Craig comes and, yeah, and then it goes south because now people in the audience are asking him about whether he's Satoshi and the whole focus is no longer on Bitcoin SV. It's on Craig. I mean, Jimmy would be cool. Jimmy Song is... Yeah, no, not this Jimmy. It's another Jimmy. This Jimmy and Jimmy Song are two different Jimmys. Completely the opposites. Yeah. So don't overuse caps, but no need to time out. No need to time out. Don't overuse. But yeah, my titles are in caps. But let's not overuse caps in... VFU, thanks for the help, but it's okay, people can have some caps, as long as they're not like, you know, spamming caps every second, but some caps, I don't have issues with that. What do you expect from Andreas's Elon guide? I think it's gonna be technical. I mean, this is not gonna be a guide. This is gonna be technical. Just like his Mastering Bitcoin book is technical, if Mastering Ethereum book is technical, this is also gonna be technical. So it's not gonna be a guide in any way. If you want a guide, go check out his YouTube channel, basically. How do you sell gold? Which currency still have a paper form? No currency will have paper form in 20 years. Even today, I mean, so many currencies are disappearing in their paper form. K Can you? So look, I was supposed to interview him, to be honest with you. That is why I went to San Francisco like a month ago to meet Warren Buffett and Justin Sun. And although I got to meet Justin Sun, that was interesting. They canceled the lunch with Warren Buffett, so I couldn't meet him. But if I got to talk to him now, I would definitely ask him about his cash stack. I mean, why so much cash, Warren? Because I think he's preparing for something, that he has this war chest. He sold so much equity and he sold so many other assets to have so much cash. So I think he's preparing for big opportunities. Pay him Ivan no free. In Germany, currencies will be in paper form. I know, like in Europe, you go to Germany, you need to have paper. That is true. But I think they're also changing. I've been trying his best to provide good content, been watching him, nice, a lot of newbies, thanks bro, appreciate, because there is no, Justin Sun should change his family name, right, can I bring you coffee beans from San Francisco this Friday, man, bring me all coffee beans, I will start mixing them, like with, what is called, like with, but what is it called? Like the grinder. Is it called grinder? Does he have to, Warren Buffett? Man, I can do him for free. I can do it for free. He doesn't need. But if he wants to, if Berkshire Hathaway wants to sponsor the channel, man, if Berkshire Hathaway Inc. dot, if they want to sponsor the channel, no problem, man. We will give them the best deal. We will give them an even better deal than Bybit. That, you know, we have a collaboration with. You can use link below, $60 for free. You can long, you can short, you can do leverage. But with leverage, be extremely careful. You can also do Bitcoin. You can do Ethereum, EOS, and XRP. So Warren, if you want some kind of collaboration like this, where I just give you shout out to Berkshire, I'm up to it, man. I'm up to it. We can do some serious Berkshire Hathaway shilling together. This is gonna be a great collaboration. The greatest collaboration crypto has ever seen. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. Obviously, I'm joking. Thank you so much for watching. This has been a great time with you. Great time with you as always. I always enjoy this. I mean, it's amazing to do this, these streams together each and every day. I hope you enjoyed as well, and I see you all tomorrow at 8 a.m. because tomorrow is Friday, and we do streams in Fridays, and that's gonna be amazing. So come back tomorrow. Have a good Thursday, and I'll see you all very very soon. Have a great day and goodbye. Smash the like, smash the bell, and goodbye, guys. Goodbye.